fairly fast and heavy air, and you're not as big as the rest of us.
Well, I've actually sort of figured out that as I've gotten older, I've gotten weaker. And what that translated into was that I wouldn't shoot as hard as I used to. And maybe you can add to this, and maybe I'm just making this up in my mind, but if you don't sheet really hard and heavy air, your sail becomes full, right? Even if you've got max bang and outhaul and Cunningham on and your travel's down, when you ease that sheet, your sail becomes bigger. And when I started thinking about this was when Zach Clayton, who probably weighs, you know, 50 pounds less than me, went sailing right over the top of me in 15 knots of breeze. And I just sort of figured it out that I wasn't cheating hard enough. And it seems sort of counterintuitive. Puff comes and you want to ease. But I've really been working on just, you know, cranking on the main sheet and trying to just sort of lay that mainsail out so that you don't, you know, fill it up, make it a big full sail when you're, you know, in a 18 knot puff.
And when you're blading that mainsail, how far in will you bring the boom?
Well, you know, in that kind of rig, we're talking about vang sheeting. So the vang helps a lot to sort of replace the main sheet sheeting. But, you know, traveler all the way down in a tight main sheet and a tight vang is better than traveler in the middle and a loose main sheet and a tight vang. So the vang's really going to help you from being able to let the sail out and not, you know, have the boom come up and the sail get fuller, right?
Right.
But if the traveler's all the way down and you still have the main sheet pulled in, then you've still got that extra advantage of keeping the sail just like well and wide.
Do you have any pointing ability at that point when you've got your traveler all the way out there, you know, like?
Yeah, but I mean, you sort of have to sail these boats, I'll say fat, not the mainsail, but, you know, bow down because you're just crashing it